Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So if you've been diving deep into the skincare world, then you have definitely come across two words, and that is AHA and BHA. And in today's video, I want to dissect these two acids. AHAs are alpha hydroxy acids, while BHA stands for beta hydroxy acids. They have many similarities, starting off with that they are both chemical exfoliators. They both even out skin tone. They're both good anti-aging mechanisms. They unclog pores. They remove dead cells, etc. But one major difference is that AHAs are water soluble, while BHAs are oil soluble. What that means is that AHAs are better for dry skin, sun damaged skin. You're basically looking for some moisture and some exfoliation while at it. BHAs are oil soluble, so they're perfect for breaking down the oils in our skin, and that's why they're recommended for acne-prone skin. Alpha hydroxy acids are made from sugary fruits, and the two types of AHAs are glycolic acid and lactic acid. The main type of BHA is salicylic acid. AHAs work by peeling off the surface of the skin so that new cells can regenerate. BHAs work by penetrating the skin. They go deep into your pores and clean out all that excess sebum and also break down dead cells. You need to be careful with AHAs and BHAs in terms of their concentration. Highly concentrated products will peel away the entire outermost layer, so that means sunscreen is a must when using AHAs and BHAs. Sensitive skin types are warned to go slowly on AHAs and BHAs, especially AHA, which is often marketed safe for them. You'll be better off finding an AHA with 1 to 2% concentration and also steadily increasing your usage as you go. These two chemical exfoliators can be used every day, and you can also use AHAs and BHAs at the same time. But you need to go rotating them in your regimen. That is, if you're using AHA today, you're not supposed to use BHAs as well. I think you'd be safer trying out one at a time. Start off with whichever you prefer, move on to the next one, and then maybe you can now mix them in your routine. And also, when you're using an AHA or a BHA like salicylic acid, these active ingredients shouldn't be mixed with other active ingredients in your regimen. So if you're using an AHA tonight, you don't want a retinol involved in the regimen as well. And also, I'll say it again because sunscreen is super important. Do not forget to wear your sunscreen when you are using these two products. So when debating on whether to go for an AHA or a BHA, remember that it all depends on your goal. Are you going for anti-aging? Do you want an acne solution? Is it hyperpigmentation? It all depends on what you want. Above all, before making a purchase, make sure that you are well informed about that particular product. What is the concentration? What AHAs are in it? What do those AHAs do? So I hope this was an insightful video and that you learned something from this. If you did, definitely leave me a thumbs up. I'll see you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye for now.